started playing World of Warcraft, actually, back when he was 11, 12. And League of Legends came later. But actually, me and the rest of the family didn't know that he was a good player in League of Legends. But we found out eventually.
Jamen, jeg har flere i vores omgangskreds, der følger lidt med os. Og i starten, da jeg sagde, han spillede computer, og kan man leve af det? Så sagde det ved jeg ikke. Jeg tror, han lever temmelig godt, men det er i hvert fald hans interesse. Det er det, han vil.
This season I've been like better, but I feel like I was always pretty good. At least maybe like besides the first split I had ever in LCS, but maybe like after that, I feel like I was always pretty good.
He can keep it going on that Meganar, that's a lot. Flashes up, he's gonna have to use it, and it's gonna be followed. Teleport coming through as well. It's gonna be perks coming in. Let's see if Prophet can get the kill. Hextech ultimatum comes out. Oh. That all in at the level 7, the Prophet says, hey, no fair, you got a 1-on-2. He hops in, and he's outplayed. First blood for Wunder.
We've just been playing together, living together for like 2 or 3 years, and he was like my teammate, but I saw him as my biggest competitor in a way. I mean, he was just always so insanely good at the game, and I just didn't understand, like, he's 2 years younger than me, and his game knowledge was always, like, really good.
Wunder on G2 has definitely been the unsung hero of the spring split. He has been a consistent performer all year long, and while he may not necessarily have all of the spotlight, because there are bigger names and there are bigger things to discuss, there's no doubt that he's continuing to shine. Whether it's on carries, whether it's on tanks, it is just this element of high performance that Wunder brings to every game.
You can really see the kid that was 17 years old a couple of years ago compared to now, much more understanding of playing as a team, much more understanding of how to communicate, while still being so good as this carry top laner. And that's why he's become probably the second most important player on G2 Esports.
He's finding that if he plays carries, if he takes over the lane and takes over the game, he is the guy that G2 can rely on. And I think that's the way he's played himself much more in the spotlight than I've seen him in the previous 2 years put together.
Ladies and gentlemen of Denmark, in the Royal Arena, put your hands together for the Spring Split Finals!
Doesn't want to go toe to toe. Shot back and forward.
He's going to kill him. That's the Predator.
Going forward. The Quadra. The Penta kill. For Reckless. For Reckless. Are you kidding me?
Penta kill.
And Fnatic will turn their attention to the Nexus. Fnatic topple G2 and are your Spring Split champions.
Losing 3-0 could have been more painful than it is if it was maybe in a different country and I had like no fans and no one that could like cheer me up. I don't take a loss like this too hard because I know what went wrong, and like I know, like, of course I'm sad about it and I would have liked to win, but I know that they were the better team, and that once you, like, I guess tell yourself that or admit that, then it's like also easier to, I guess, get over the loss.
Han har udviklet sig helt enormt. Han er blevet meget voksen. Og selvom han ikke er så meddelsom om, hvad der sker, så kan man jo mærke, at han socialiserer sig på en anden måde og bruger os på en anden måde, end han har gjort før. Så der er klart sket et stort spring, specielt for Splice her nu til G2, at han er blevet mere frigjort og afslappet.